So imagine 45,000 fans, all hungry for hurling and football and whatever else might be on offer in this fine new stadium. Let's talk about the business of Páirc Uí Chaoimh. I'm Jonathan Healy and this is Red Business.
This has been designed to be state-of-the-art, to be as good as any of the stadia that we have in Ireland. I think it's definitely up there with the Aviva, with Croke Park, or with Thomond and the facilities there. We will have eating facilities for upwards of 600 people at a time here. We have three bars, we have a cafe. And of course then the section behind us actually will be converted into an event centre, or conference centre in essence. But certainly, you know, we've got definitive plans, I think, for concerts next year, in all likelihood starting in May. We were probably too late for the summer market this year, and there would have been uncertainty around various elements of the stadium. So, but now that we're closer to the opening, which is going to be at the end of next month, we're very confident that we can provide promoters like Aiken and Desmond what they want in terms of the ergonomics of the stadium.
So in real terms, we could have concerts here next summer?
I think we will have definitely concerts next summer, and starting in all likelihood in May.
You know, how close are you to opening the doors and letting the public come in and see it?
Yeah, well, look, we're obviously very close, right? There's about 420 people here on site every day. So it just gives you a sense of the amount of activity that's going on here. Things change here very fast. I suppose our big day is 2nd of July, which fixtures allowing, we'll have the Munster football final between Kerry and Cork. So that's kind of the big day for us.
What's it like to be so close to this being finished right now?
Well, it's fantastic. I think when you think about the number of work days that have gone into this project, from hundreds of people, probably up to 1,000 different people have been involved in various segments of the contract. But now when you actually see the seats in, when you see, you know, it taking real shape, when you start to see the sod appearing, when you see the barriers going into the city and into the Black Rock end, you get a sense that, yeah, there's a great excitement about the place opening, and we can't wait for that Rebel Roar on the first Sunday in July.